Hey everyone, welcome back. A new TLDR means a new Grafana release, and more specifically, 12.2. This release keeps building on the momentum from GrafanaCon back in May when 12.0 was originally launched. If we take a quick trip down memory lane, the 12.0 release came with smarter filters, SQL expressions, and a lineup of powerful features to make the visualization experience even better. But summer has passed and fall is here, and now 12.2 is here. You can view this as yet another evolution of Grafana where 12.0 features have grown more stable and new stuff is beginning to emerge. Let's kick things off with one of the biggest upgrades in 12.2, Ad-Hoc Filters. And these are now generally available in Grafana OSS, Cloud, and Enterprise. Ad-Hoc Filters are an awesome improvement for the Grafana platform because up until now, filtering from SQL data sources has been limited and sort of unreliable. But starting in 12.2, you now have the dynamic option to toggle on ad-hoc filters per visualization panel. For example, if we have a variable filter on our dashboard and have three panels selected, maybe two with ad-hoc filters enabled, one without, we can now select a value on a bar chart per se and add that as a filter reliably to make sure the two panels reflect our changes. This is supported for all SQL data sources. The best part is this isn't just for tables anymore. You can even set filters straight from a bar chart tooltip. A lot smoother of a UX experience if you ask me, and it's part of a theme you'll notice in 12.2, doing more with fewer clicks. Speaking of fewer clicks, SQL expressions are now in public preview, moving from private preview back in 12.0 in Grafana OSS, Cloud, and Enterprise. The new editor is streamlined with clean formatting, quick actions, and one-click runs. And what's even better is it's compatible with the Grafana LLM plugin. So if you need a query, you can just ask it in plain language. You got a messy query from a teammate maybe, you can ask Grafana to explain it and walk away a little less confused and needing to wait on a Slack response from them. Now queries are super great, right? But sometimes dashboards need to actually do something. They need to perform some sort of action. And that's where actions with the Infinity data source come into play. The Infinity data source is already super powerful because it can query and visualize data from JSON, CSV, GraphQL, XML, and even HTML, right? And now in 12.2, actions can tap into those same pre-configured authenticated connections. Previously, actions were stuck in the browser and honestly, oftentimes blocked by CORS issues. But with Infinity handling the authentication on the server side, you can securely trigger actions that require credentials right from your dashboards. To try it out, just enable the Viz Actions Auth feature toggle. Just note that users with the viewer role can't see or execute these actions. The canvas, which is a beloved visualization type in Grafana, also got a huge upgrade, a re-engineered pan and zoom. Now when using the canvas panel, you can move around freely, drop elements anywhere, keep layouts stable, and use the new zoom to content toggle to snap everything perfectly into view. I kind of view this like Google Earth for your canvas panels. The canvas improvements are now in public preview for Grafana OSS, Cloud, and Enterprise. You can try this out now in 12.2 by enabling the canvas panel pan zoom feature toggle. And let's not forget about some of our most beloved visualization types, which is the table, right? The new tables view is generally available in all Grafana deployments, Cloud, OSS, and Enterprise, but got a major glow up. You can think pill cells, Markdown and HTML support, frozen columns, wrapped headers, tooltips, and a cleaner footer. Tables now make your data shine and your layouts are extremely flexible. But tables aren't the only thing that got a facelift in 12.2. The logs Drilldown JSON Viewer is also now generally available in Grafana 11.6 and later. And of course, available in 12.2. What's nice about this is instead of squinting at raw JSON, which we've all done, you now get a structured, collapsible view that makes log data instantly understandable. Filtering on a single field and excluding noisy nested JSON is just one click away. The result of this is faster log analysis and dashboards that stay focused on the information that truly matters, not just a bunch of JSON cruft. Of course, Grafana releases always expand the big tent of data sources. In 12.2, there's a new Jenkins Enterprise data source only available in Grafana Cloud and Enterprise. The new Jenkins data source supports projects, builds, queues, and nodes, basically all the metrics you need for DORA performance tracking. That means you can finally line up your delivery pipeline data with your other observability data and see how code moves from commit to production, all within Grafana. And finally, for all you heavy alerting users, we didn't forget about you. The queryless experience just got a heck of a lot better with the metrics drill down tab now being an entry point from the alert rule editor. This is generally available across Grafana OSS, Cloud, and Enterprise. You may be asking, why does this really even matter? Well, when it comes to PromQL, getting that proper query for a given metric can be tricky, and Drilldown helps with that by providing a queryless experience. You can think of this as sort of the first evolution to making the alert and Drilldown experience unified. By simply clicking Go Queryless, jumping into Drilldown, then adding a few label filters maybe and selecting a metric, you can take that exact query, jump into Explore, copy and paste it, and then jump back into your alert. Expect this workflow to get more seamless in upcoming releases. Here's the 12.2 TLDR and yet another evolution of Grafana. Make sure to go upgrade today, try out the previews, and as always, let us know what you think in the comments below or maybe even in GitHub. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and check the What's New blog for full details. See you in the next release.